Question. Does our state do enough to prevent distracted driving? I would say no, it does not do enough to protect against distracted driving. And here's why. And it's simply because it has so many options for policies to enforce. Because these laws aren't about like, oh, this is more convenient, or we could pass this more easily. No, these policies are about saving lives. And if you can't save lives as easily as just researching something and then, just bringing it up in court, if that isn't a thing, then the system should be fixed. Because I do not think it's a moral thing to force people to spend over $200,000 to go through some crazy legal battle that lasts like so many years, and by the time that he actually finishes it, like 50, 60, 70, 80, maybe like 1,000 people have died by the time that he's finished it. Actually, no, 3,000 since in a year, I think it was like 2012. Is it a source somewhere? In like 2012 in Florida, there were like 2,900 car crashes. Car crash fatalities. So if this guy doesn't win this court case within that much time, then the state has killed 2,900 people. And the options to do this are they're not limited at all. There are many, many things. Like for instance, sticking a camera inside of someone's car to force them to not text and drive. Maybe have a loud beep that happens when they whip out a phone and like use it, right? Maybe force everyone to use a breathalyzer test. Or, I mean not or, I mean and you can make it so cars do not start when you have your seatbelt in. Maybe make it illegal for all manufacturers to not have that device in place that measures distances between cars and prevents crashes. You've seen those commercials, right? Force all manufacturers to do it, get into their finances, and make them sell them for cheap. I don't, because I don't care about what profits they make. It's cars, okay? You're supposed to sell them for cheap so everyone can have them. It's mass manufacturing. You're not supposed to scam the crap out of everyone just so you can get your grubby hands on some money. That's something else that I am against. The thing is, forcing cameras to be in people's cars, it's not illegal. It isn't, because once you're outside of your property, once you're outside of your garage, that's public property. You physically cannot be nude in your car. You can't do something dumb like go to the bathroom in your car. Like, oh, I got a toilet in my back seat. Ooh, yeah. You cannot do any of those things. This is public. And sure, the car is the proper your property, but we have regulations on everything. All right, I don't think you're not even supposed to use like specific kinds of paint. All right, it's your property, right? You can't use specific kinds of paint on your house. So why? What's the difference between that and forcing people to buy like a $20, $30 camera? None. There is no difference. It's surveillance, right? In a public area. And even if it does intrude on people's privacy, it's still saving lives. So your feelings end where someone's life begins. All right, that is a fact.